not to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite when they're coming to take your freedom.
From the planet Earth. You're looking at my uploads page and you'll see that the radio show I did last night about the Million Mask March and current state of the revolution is still processing, which should not happen, has never happened. I only used it a few times, the live broadcast, but every time it's been great. Mayhem and Madness was up last night in an appropriate amount of time. No weird changes, no reason for this at all. The reason I did the show is because a group that I'm involved with on Google Plus has indications that this year's protest in D.C. will be met with violence. And I've had a thesis really from the beginning of what we know as the Million Mask March, or within the first several months, and I've just been watching. I haven't gone to D.C. I won't go to D.C. And what I think is that, quite honestly, John Anthony Fairhurst and Wiki Poet are a good cop, bad cop scenario. And there's some key reasons for thinking that. First one is any government control program would not be efficient with one entity because not everybody agrees with one single person. But two is very effective. You can find enough likes among you to go to one side or the other. You feel like you have a choice. Blah, blah, blah. Works in politics, right? Okay. That's the first point. Second point is we know a lot about Wiki Poet from Occupy Oakland, her stint in the UK. People there believe same thing, I believe. Many of you believe. And this whole time, the focus has been on Poet. Because she's so out there and so outlandish and trying to claim leadership of Anonymous. And, well, this is the thing. If you look at videos, interviews that John has had, the commentators will call him a member of Anonymous and then tell you what his name is. Well, that kind of negates the whole idea, I think. Second of all, it proclaims to be the originator of the Million Mask March movement. And input I'm getting from other people is that's not the case. And in essence, I know it's not the case because the movement really started from Anonymous roots in the UK in, I believe, 2011, when Anonymous activists marched against Parliament on November 5th and they asked other people around the world to stand up. The Million Mask March movement did not originate in the United States, and I want you to think about this. The Anonymous movement is very powerful, and if they start marching on world governments, our government is going to want to control that immediately. It has to, because it knows we have the power. It needs to keep us distracted. It needs to keep us divided. And also think about this. It needs to pull all the groups that are out there under one flag, so to speak. Now, I want you to think about this. The Million Mask March on D.C. has not grown. It has not accomplished anything. It has pulled together, in some fashion, all the major groups that are actually accomplishing things. March against Monsanto, they're shutting shit down. All the different groups that are protesting against Nestle, they're shutting shit down. Nuclear activists shutting things down. These groups are making an impact. And as far as a federal entity, that we know that all the things those groups are shutting down are funding the government, so controlling it, whatever. Okay, there's a lot here. Now we know Wiki Poet has spread out all over the internet with tons of websites. John has done the same thing with Facebook pages. Now, John is supposed to be one of us, just a working guy. And if you look at the amount of time he puts into all this and all the pages that he has set up all over the world, that you can't, one man can't do that. Well, wait a minute. One man can do that. Yeah, especially if you're using software. One person could be 50 people. Yeah, that's the funny thing. So one man can do that. Right. So if we have web pages all over the place and we have Facebook accounts all over the place, how come there's not just as many Twitter accounts? That's curious too, isn't it? There is a Twitter account, of course, but when you look, it's just an auto post from Facebook, bringing people back to Facebook. I don't think any of us question what Facebook is there for. This can't go on anymore. We're not being effective. The only result of the Million Mask March is that it's drained people's resources. I've seen a single mother from Littleton, New Hampshire, struggle to get to D.C., suffer consequences for going to D.C., and worry the whole time that she wasn't going to make it to D.C., just exhausted her. I saw a man, Michael Pendleton, shout out to you, Michael, walking. He felt so serious about this, he walked from Florida to D.C. I bet he won't do it again. Okay, now, another curious thing. I announced that I was going to do this show when indications of violence were... You know, I don't listen to the first thing someone tells me, but when you hear something repeatedly, you know that you probably better listen up. And it's been repeated many times through anonymous channels that the D.C. event will be met with violence. And that absolutely plays into my thesis, because the whole idea is to destroy the name of Anonymous and to glean information about those people that are actually doing something. I announced this show on the 20th. I didn't specifically invite John, schedule him to be a guest, because I didn't want anyone to think that this is a personal attack. I've never met the man. When the man reached out to me after Alex Jones turned him down for a radio show, I put him on air. He scared the hell out of everybody on the network. That's when I started looking at this movement. Because if we're going to form a movement that involves everybody, and we expect the average American sheeple to take part, we can't be violent. We can't. The Million Mask March isn't growing because all it was designed to do was to pull out the radicals, the ones that are over the top. And there's other things it was designed to do, like cause infighting. Tell me that's not going on. It's ridiculous. It has diminished the name of Anonymous, and many Anonymous aren't supporting the Million Mask March. They're still fighting world governments. They're still doing what they do. But they're not promoting the Million Mask March. There's no reason that when you go to the official page right now, there's only 25,000 people that say they're going. I think last year it was up to like 50 or 60,000. Of course, not a fraction of them showed up. I also was going to invite Kevin Blanch, but I didn't call Kevin into the show. He was going to make himself available, although he was protesting a nuclear plant, but he was still going to be available by phone, and I wanted him there because, again, this isn't personal. I trust Kevin Blanch. He's one of those people I've watched for a long time. He's never changed his spots, and he knows his shit. And he was actually in D.C. He's actually met John and communicated with John. So that, I thought, would bring balance. But when John didn't show up, I don't know why John didn't show up. I let him know about the show the same time I let everybody else know about the show. In fact, when I put a reminder up a day before, I tagged him in it, along with a bunch of other people. Yeah. Where was John last night? At the bar. Now you may say, well, no, this is where his girlfriend works. He was going to the bar. When Alex Jones turned him down, he ran to me and asked me to get him on air. And now when I want to talk about what's going on, he's nowhere to be found. He doesn't show up. The video won't process. I'm asking you all, stay away from D.C. Support the original idea of the movement and protest at your state capitals. Don't waste your resources to travel to D.C. where you could be trapped in violence to parade around outside of a building that's closed. You know the federal government isn't listening to you anyway. That's why you're doing this. Well, it's time to force your state government to stand up against D.C. folks. You haven't gathered enough people to do a goddamn thing. You haven't shut D.C. down. You've been allowed to protest around a certain area, and that's all it's amounted to. It's a psyop full of sock puppets. And every one of you now gleaned all your information, all your connections, 3 years of surveillance, not one bit of growth. Wake up. And John, you know, I've seen you work very hard, excessively hard. It's unexplainable for a guy that's supposed to be working every day. I put a lot of time in. I know how exhausted I am, but you do even more than I do, according to this march. And one more key point. The tipping factor for calling you out, John, was when you put up the page encouraging kids to walk out of school on November 5th. We cannot do that. We're not the fucking Pied Piper. Yes, I want those kids awake. Yes, I want those kids protesting. But I want it done with the guidance of their parents. Their parents have that right. You have no right to overstep that line, to teach those kids in that manner. You have no right to do it at all. And that was when it was very clear to me. It was clear already. But that was the straw. That was the straw. You don't put kids in harm's way. The Anonymous I know don't put kids in harm's way. We fight to protect them. We don't ask them to walk out of school where they're going to get themselves in trouble and be ostracized. That's ridiculous. We ask their parents to sign them out of school and bring them with them. That's what we do. It's the ones I know do, anyway. Like my kids when I took them to the protest recently in Salem against Nestle. But it wasn't under someone else's direction. It's all wrong. It's all wrong. You're diminishing the name of Anonymous. You're putting people in harm's way. And no positive change has occurred. I hope you'll all think very, very deeply. I'm not putting any links below. You need to do your research. This is too critical for you to just take my word for it. Much love. Many thanks. And I'll see you soon.